presidentes da República Helénica, da República Italiana e da República Portuguesa, excelências, senhor diretor da Organização Europeia de Direito Público, senhoras e senhores embaixadores, senhoras e senhores ministros, magistrados e professores. Não é certamente fruto do acaso a presença de três chefes de Estado nesta cerimónia comemorativa dos 10 anos da fundação da Organização Europeia de Direito Público, como também o não será a circunstância de três presidentes da República, eleitos democraticamente de acordo com as respectivas constituições, serem ilustres académicos, professores universitários de Direito Público, desde há muito membros do Grupo Europeu de Direito Público, hoje transformado no Conselho Científico Europeu, órgão da organização.
Dear Presidents, it's such a pleasure and a honor to have you here on this occasion. Nowadays, the reason to stay together and the reason to stay together under the principles that have guided us up to now, the rule of law, the respect of human rights, mutual tolerance, understanding diversities, and understanding how to live together. These are even more essential because there might be a future for states that live their individual lives, but not in terms of hostility toward the others. Going back to the basic principle proclaimed by Robert Schuman in the Declaration of 9 May 1950, solidarity has to grow among us, which happened in the first decades and is not happening anymore. The EPLO is a sort of protective shield for these principles. The law, the meaning of the law.
Εξοχότατοι κύριοι πρόεδροι, καλώς ήρθατε στο επιστημονικό σας σπίτι.
Κύριε πρόεδρε της Ιταλικής Δημοκρατίας, αγαπημένε φίλε Σέρτζιο, κύριε πρόεδρε της Πορτογαλικής Δημοκρατίας, αγαπημένε φίλε Μαρσέλο, πάντα βρισκόσουν κοντά σε αυτόν τον τόπο, αλλά ιδίως κοντά σε αυτόν τον εμβληματικό οργανισμό, του οποίου τα 10 χρόνια γιορτάζουμε σήμερα. 10 χρόνια ζωής, 10 χρόνια αγώνα. Αυτός ο αγώνας μας κάνει να γινόμαστε πιο δυνατοί όταν ξέρουμε τι μπορεί να προσφέρει ο Ευρωπαϊκός Οργανισμός Δημοσίου Δικαίου στην κοινή μας οικογένεια, στην Ευρώπη μας. Θα κάνουμε ό,τι μπορούμε για να στηρίξουμε τον Ευρωπαϊκό Οργανισμό στην πορεία του προς ένα μέλλον το οποίο ανήκει στην Ευρώπη. Δεν το κάνουμε γιατί είμαστε γνωστοί μεταξύ μας ή απλώς και μόνο γιατί μας οδήγησαν τα βήματα της επαγγελματικής σταδιοδρομίας εδώ. Το κάνουμε γιατί έχουμε αγωνία για την Ευρώπη.
Signor Presidente Papadopoulos, signor Presidente Rebelo de Sousa, professor Flogaitis, autorità, signore e signori, la forza di questa organizzazione risiede nello studio, nella capacità di approfondimento, nella ricerca, nella proposta di sviluppo di comuni principi del diritto in Europa. Quello che nel maggio dell'anno passato a Roma, a Palazzo del Quirinale, il professor Sabino Cassese definiva il nuovo Ius Commune Europeum. L'EPLO può e deve essere realmente tra i protagonisti di una stagione nuova europea, capace di mostrare ancora una volta regole e modelli sociali che accrescano la qualità della convivenza. Da parte nostra non le faremo mancare il nostro convinto sostegno. Questo è l'augurio e l'impegno dell'Italia per l'EPLO e per i prossimi 10 anni.
Signor Presidente della Repubblica Elenica, signor Presidente della Repubblica Italiana, signor Presidente Amado, caro professor Servo Correia, caríssimo Spiridon Flagaitis, your statements were very impressive concerning Europe. Europe the past, Europe the present, and Europe the future. We are lawyers, we are law professors, we are judges. We know how important is law and the rule of law. But one thing is the rule of law, the other one is the way you reinforce it, you accept it, you live it. And sometimes we have forgotten to live upon the principles of our European law. I used to say to my students that one of the problems of these times is how everything changes. Economy, finance, society, culture. But law and politics are always, always backwards. We must anticipate, not react. Europe has been reacting too late to the change in the world and to the change in Europe. And that's the challenge for the next future. That is the challenge. That is our challenge. You must believe in Europe. It's impossible to build a Europe with politicians that do not believe in Europe. You must trust the people. It's impossible to build a new Europe forgetting the people, not explaining to the people in a confidentialist way. It's impossible. And we lawyers, we politicians, must try to convince our colleagues everywhere in Europe that what really unifies us is more important than what divides us. We must try our best to get a way of unity, understanding the vital principles of our law and of our ideal of Europe. And that's why it's so important we are here with our dear Spiridon Flagaitis. The presence of the Portuguese president shows that we support this organization.